Learn how to create a free website, a step-by-step guide directly to create your own website, combining personal or small projects. On freenom.com, type a name for your project, and if available, you can register as a free domain name. When a name is available, we jump to this page, and here, we're going to use our name servers that we'll paste later on. We define the registration length. And next, after we pass this picture control, we're going to need a hosting service. On 000webhost.com, we can host our free domain. Type your free domain, your personal or nickname, an email address, and your password. Type the CAPTCHA words, agree to the terms of service, click to create, and then go to your email address to confirm your account. Now go to Control Panel. In View Account Details, we're going to copy the name servers. Then we jump back to freenom.com, and we're going to paste this name servers. And now we can register our free domain. Type an email address, and click Next. Enter your freenom, email and password, to add this domain name to your account. And then you can log in. Now to manage this domain name, go to My Domains, and click to Manage Domain. And in Management Tools, is where you change the name servers. Now back to our hosting service control panel. We need to create MySQL database. Type a database name, a username and a password. And copy this details to the clipboard or elsewhere. You will need this info, for instance, if you install a content management system like WordPress, to paste into the wp-config file. Now, the issue here is the name servers to propagate. Could take up 48 hours to take effect, just be patient. When ready, you will see a page like this. It's the default.php file. You find this file inside the public HTML directory of your website. If you go to File Manager in Control Panel, or from an FTP program, navigate to the public folder, and you'll see this file there. You will need to delete or assign a different name, because we want a different default page, the one from our website. At this point, we already set a free domain name, order a hosting service, rename the name servers, create a database, but we still have to create or transfer the content of the website. So we're going to use a content management system like WordPress. The most practical way to do this is uploading WordPress folders and files to the host server. On Script Auto Installer, download from WordPress.org. Then, unzip the WordPress file and upload all files and directories inside the WordPress folder to the FTP public folder on your server and wait until the upload is completed. When it's done, return to the website address in your browser, and refresh the page. Now, choose a language, and continue. And now, is where we need the details of MySQL database, to edit the wp-config.php file. Go to your hosting, control panel, MySQL database details, and paste that info into this page. Leave the table prefix as it is, hit submit, and continue. Since you already upload WordPress, we just need fill this last information needed. Type a site title, a username, password, email, and then login. Welcome to WordPress. Now, if it is the first time you are creating a website with WordPress, I can assure you, it is not as difficult as you might think. Give it a try. You can also search for WordPress tutorials that will help you with your inquiries and questions.